Ever wonder where your garbage ends up? Most times, we bet you haven't. After all, when you throw out that hand-knitted sweater from your great Aunt Tessie, you're just happy to be rid of that thing. Sadly, it's quite likely that that sweater is going to end up in a landfill. Or, in the worst-case scenario, out in the environment. And that ain't a good thing. So, here's a question for you, Brainiacs. Why don't we just toss all our garbage into a volcano? Just drive up the side of that fiery mountain and toss it all in. Wham, bam, and done. Right? Today we are finding out if this is even possible. So, put on some rubber gloves, because we are talking garbage and whether or not we can get rid of it in volcanoes. Our current trash removal system is actually a pretty complicated and multi-step process. We all know the first step is to bag up your trash and then place it in either a bin outside or a nearby dumpster. But after that, our trash goes on quite the journey. Let's break it down for you. After being picked up by the team managing that garbage truck, the first stop is what is known as a transfer station. These facilities are where all your trash is compacted and gets ready to be sent off to the next phase in the process. The compacted trash is loaded up into bigger trucks and taken to material recovery facilities, also known as MRFs. MRFs actually come in two different types: clean and dirty MRFs. Clean means that the recyclables arriving are pre-sorted, which means that they have come from people's homes. Dirty simply means that these facilities are receiving recyclables that are mixed in with the trash. As you can imagine, these locations require a much more hands-on staff, which will also have state-of-the-art technology to recover as much usable materials as possible. Some of these technologies include magnets, shredders, and also current separators. These will determine if something is made of iron or not. As the name implies, when something arrives at the material recovery facility, it not only means the trash is sorted into all its different types, but the reusable materials will be recovered. Anything that can't? Well, it's sent to the final step in our trash process. The final destinations for our trash can be a few different places. Most times, trash ends up in a landfill. In fact, 52% of our trash ends up here. Across the US, there are over 3,000 of these trash graveyards. Landfills are actually not designed to break down our trash. When a layer in the landfill fills up, it will be lined with clay and a flexible plastic skin. Then, more trash will be placed on top. When it's full, the top layer will be lined with soil and plants. Garbage will indeed break down here, but it takes a long time, and it will take even longer than usual due to the lack of oxygen under the ground and under those plastic tarps. Trash can also end up in a recycling facility. In fact, about 35% of all solid waste ends its journey here. The goal here is simple. Get all the materials that can be used again, like paper, aluminum, glass, or plastic, and use them again. Since the 1980s, there have been more and more recycling facilities. A 2015 study by the EPA showed 67.8 million tons of municipal solid waste was recycled and used again to make the products we use daily. When it comes to food waste, many times its final resting place is at anaerobic digesters. These facilities use microorganisms to break down the food waste into energy and fertilizer. These are most commonly found on farms, but many times the food waste from grocery stores and restaurants will also end up here. It's a great way to break down that old sandwich the all-natural way. Finally, garbage can end up in trash incinerators. Oh, we see your ears perking up at this one, Brainiacs. I mean, if trash can be incinerated at a facility, how much of a stretch is it to just toss it in a volcano? Now, don't get too ahead of yourselves. Here's the scoop on incinerators. These facilities get hot, as in 1800 degrees Fahrenheit hot. And even then, this isn't always enough to turn all the trash into ash. After being thoroughly burned, the original volume of the trash that entered the facility is reduced by 95%. Hey, that ain't too bad. This significantly reduces the amount of space that trash will take up in a landfill. And another plus is, the heat that is produced can be harnessed to produce energy. Pretty cool, right? Pretty hot, right? Anyways, moving on. This brings us back to the question of volcanoes. See, there's a few extra steps that the incinerator facilities take that keep the process streamlined and safe. The biggest plus to leaving it to the professionals is how they properly handle the air pollution that inevitably exists when you burn trash. Not only is the gas produced cooled, but any chemicals or residue is extracted and then properly disposed of. Now, the non-polluted gas can be safely released through an induced draft fan and a smokestack. And now, we're back at volcanoes. Driving up the side of these things and dumping all our garbage inside would have none of these precautions. No separation or usable materials. No gas filtration system. No safe way of releasing the treated gas into the atmosphere. None of it. And we haven't even gotten into how dangerous burning trash can be for the people working at the facility. These state-of-the-art incinerators are designed to keep their staff safe, whether through the use of biohazard suits or having the controls to the machinery a safe distance away from the burning garbage or dangerous gases. These places have been built to be as safe as possible. And a volcano? Not so much. Any metals that made it into the air, well, now you'd be breathing them. And so would anyone else in the area. Plus, many times lava just ain't hot enough to melt some of the hardier metals that would be thrown into it. Molten lava is hot, don't get us wrong, but it averages about 1500 degrees Fahrenheit. Yes, it could burn a lot of what goes in, but trash incinerators stay hotter longer and more consistently. Speaking of consistency, lava pools are rare. Most volcanoes don't even have them. There are only a few scattered around the world as we speak, which brings us to the biggest problem with the old trash removal in a volcano strategy: getting the trash to these locations. Sure, Hawaii may consistently have a lava lake, but flying or sailing all that garbage over there? That takes a lot of time and money. Not only that, getting the people of Hawaii to agree to tons of garbage being thrown into their volcanic paradise? Yeah, good luck with that one. Other things to consider include lava lakes not going on forever, as well as not really being stable. The trash that we would throw in has to go somewhere, and certainly some of it would become smoke, but the majority of the garbage would sink and eventually make its way back into the soil, polluting the surrounding areas. As for stability, oh boy, do you have to worry about this one. Piercing lava's surface can cause a chain reaction where acidic steam from under the surface explodes out, and you better make sure you are out of the way when that happens. Look, we're sorry to let you down, Brainiacs. Honestly, we like where this question is coming from. Essentially, you want to know if there's a natural way we can safely dispose of our trash forever. If only there was something even hotter than volcanoes we could toss it into. Something bigger and more abundant. And not located on a paradise like Hawaii. Somewhere so far away that any potential pollution would have no chance of hurting us here on Earth. Oh wait! What about the sun? We can just blast all our garbage into the sun! Right? Well, the sun is definitely hot enough to incinerate any garbage, and considering that 1.3 million Earths can fit inside of it, we'd say that it's plenty abundant. We'd even go so far as to say that because the sun is so far away from the Earth, and its gravitational pull is so strong, that any pollution made would either not affect us or get sucked right in. Gotta say, this plan doesn't seem so bad. Well, until you start to think about the logistics of it, that is. See, it's not so much that we couldn't throw our trash into the sun, it's more a question of how in the world we would get it there. If we used traditional rockets to accomplish this task, it would require a rocket so huge and would use so much fuel that it would be more massive and more powerful than any we have currently constructed. Remember, it's not just breaking Earth's gravity you'd have to worry about, but you'd have to slow the rocket as it approaches the sun just enough that it breaks orbit and then falls into the sun. This would require a lot of fuel. In fact, it would require less fuel to launch our garbage out of the solar system than into the sun. Wrap your head around that one, Brainiacs. On top of this, there is always a chance of launch failure. And if something went wrong and the rocket exploded, then all of that hazardous material is now in our atmosphere. Plus, with the current pricing of sending a rocket to space, this little project would be monstrously expensive. There's no way we'd get it off the ground. maybe someday, if technology gets cheaper, better, and we find an alternative fuel source. But as of today, this one is just science fiction, Brainiacs. And with that, we've answered all your burning questions with regards to burning trash in volcanoes. Hey, we hear ya. On the surface, it seems like a fantastic idea. I mean, these natural fiery furnaces seem like the perfect place to toss any unwanted garbage. Again, your great Aunt Tessie's sweater comes to mind. But it just ain't that simple. Garbage, unfortunately, wouldn't just magically disappear into lava. We say continue to sort your trash. Recycle. Use reusable materials like cloth bags when you head to the grocery store. And keep doing your part to keep our planet clean and beautiful. We'll see you next time, Brainiacs.